So, my first question. Why do you believe in the theory of evolution? Would you say that's faith? Yes or no? Why?
This guy's lobbing up softball, so I think I will try to yank one out of the park. I don't believe in evolution, I accept evolution. I understand that it is a fact. I don't believe that there's a country called New Zealand. I just accept that it's a fact. And no, it's not based on faith. I don't have faith in New Zealand. I have a highly reasonable, highly educated guess, which is all we can do, is make highly educated guesses, if you want to get technical about it. So no, I don't know there's a New Zealand, but I'm pretty goddamn sure there is.
Question number two. Can you show me one observed example of a change in kinds, not an adaptation of, oh, a virus became a virus? I want to see some animal changing into another animal. Don't give me that humans breeded dogs because we all know that man did that. Oh, well, you see, we made wolves into dogs and humans did it, but it's evolution. No, it's not evolution because we did it. And you're like, okay, then who created God? Okay, basically. He's eternal. There's no beginning, there's no end. Our minds can't even comprehend that. That's just too much.
So, by definition, our little puny minds can't comprehend the very thing you just said. So, how are you comprehending it? So, your mind has just enough capacity to comprehend that you cannot comprehend? Amazing.
There's no beginning. No end, and like we go back 1,000 million trillions of quadruple killions of years, and he's still there, and we're like, wait, that doesn't make any sense.
Well, I just Googled it, and it turns out we don't go back 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, period of time. I will grant you that.
But you see, our brains are just, we're just small little brains. Like, we're not, we can't even comprehend that until we get into the afterlife, and we will have supreme knowledge of what, or we'll be like, oh, shit, this is what's going on here.
How convenient.
My third question is, why are you afraid of the Bible? I'm not afraid of for the Bible. It's just bullshit. Have you even read it? How much have you read of it? If anything, if you don't believe it, it's a great freaking book. It has so many great morals and it predicts the future that actually happened now, so. And if you don't believe me, just look it up. Bible Prophecy, New World Order. Check that out. Like, that's just... There's stuff about 9/11 in there?
No. No, we will not be doing searches of any kind on Bible Prophecy, New World Order. I would rather shoot myself in the left eyeball. Are you kidding me? Yeah, it's kind of easy to make prophecies come true when you reverse engineer the goddamn books. What kind of a simpleton would you have to be to actually believe in the prophecy of a bunch of dudes writing about long past events, non-events? Writing about long past fictional events, having read the long past fictional events of a previous book, and then cobbling the two together in some haphazard, ridiculous manner, filled with one contradiction after another. That, yeah, very challenging. And did he say good morals? Pfft. Holy fuck. Filled with good morals. Oh my god. How do they say that with a straight face? I would love to see a list of what they think those good morals are. What I love is whenever this comes up, they sort of always go to the Ten Commandments, like the Ten Popular Commandments, and they go, you know, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal. And then it's like a massive drop-off. It goes off a cliff. Like, you don't hear anything else. Nobody's hyping up, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife. Okay? Perhaps because... You could say the gazillion dollar industry of porn is all coveting thy neighbor's wife. Now, granted, many of these women in question are not married, per se, but it is a lot of coveting going on, okay? The stats are in. We've had a few years of the internet. That commandment is not quite being followed precisely right now at this current stage in human history. And it's like, yeah, thou shalt not kill or steal. Thanks, Christians. Thank you. Couldn't figure that one out. Golden rule, the platinum rule. The platinum rule is don't be an asshole. So with the platinum rule and the golden rule, couldn't figure out don't kill people. And then you might want to put a big asterisk on that in the Bible, because there are thousands of times, millions of times, where killing is condoned and requested by the creator of the universe. So it's not just thou shalt not kill. No, there's more nuance there. Thou shalt not kill unless I tell you to kill every man, woman, child, and beast of a certain group of people. Then, yeah, thou shalt kill. Please.
I'm not going to do the research for you, because I'm kind of lazy, but don't be as lazy as me. You see, the Bible, what it is now, isn't the original Bible. It's been manipulated through the years. It's like, if you took a picture of a painting with your cell phone camera, and then your friend took a picture of your cell phone of the painting, and then his friend took another picture of the cell phone, that's like the evolution of the Bible. Just answer those three questions. I'm not asking for 12 paragraphs, that's why I'm not asking 12 questions, just three. Just answer those three.